Hey guys, James here, and this is a walkthrough for Tales of Ixalia. Hey guys, welcome back to the walkthrough. In the last video, we entered Order Palace and confronted Noctigal. At the end of our confrontation, someone assassinated Noctigal, and now we're going to find the Lance of Presnik. Now this part's going to be a lot more cutscenes than action again, I'm sorry. But there is some action.
We're too late.
It's gone! Are you sure it was even here?
Noctigal absorbed the Lance's energy before fighting us. It had to have been here.
Gillen's gone as well. Maybe he moved it.
If the Lance made it outside, it could be anywhere by now. Let us leave the palace.
So the Lance is missing, and we believe Gillen took it somewhere, but we don't
know
where.
Can't figure it out. Who could have fired those arrows that killed Noctigal?
I have no idea, but for an instant, I sensed a strength that was equal to the power of a great spirit.
Well, it's definitely not your pals, since they're trapped in the Lance. Wasn't there also talk about a great spirit-like presence in the attack on Himmel?
There are two possibilities. Either the enemy has found a way to control the Four, or there are other great spirits of which I am not aware.
So we're going to end up fighting a great spirit either way. Wonderful.
So there's basically nothing left for us to do here now, so we just gotta leave Order Palace and find out where the Lance is somewhere else. Now it shouldn't be too difficult to leave Order Palace due to the warp areas around. But before I actually leave, I'm gonna quickly scan this area to make sure I didn't miss any chests before I leave the palace. But I do believe once we leave the palace, we'll get more insight to where the Lance of Kresnik could be.
Identify yourselves!
Uh-oh. This ain't good.
Hey, hold on. Aren't you Chief Hilbert?
That is correct.
I have a message! Let me through!
What is it?
Azul's army is on the march! The enemy force is said to exceed 50,000 men!
The war. It started.
Order the troops. To attack!
Forward to victory!
Forward to victory!
Forward to victory!
Prepare to attack!
Forward to victory!
Prepare to attack!
Prepare to attack!
Forward to victory!
Forward to victory!
Prepare to attack!
Forward to victory!
Prepare to attack!
1,000? From Sapstrath?
No, they're coming from north of Finmont. They're in Fezabel Marsh.
Impossible. How do they intend to march across such impassable terrain? The spirit climbs have stopped shifting.
Chief Ilbert, we are unable to decipher their method of transportation.
This is bad, isn't it? All our soldiers are concentrated in Fort Gundala and at sea.
At this point, we may not have time to move our troops into position.
You need not worry. Deputy Chief of Staff Gillen foresaw this attack. He is transporting our new weapon to the battlefield as we speak.
I knew it.
Soldier, who ordered you to carry this message?
The Deputy Chief himself. Is something wrong?
No. You are dismissed.
Gilland is up to something.
Whatever it is, we must head to Fezabel Marsh at once.
So it's clear our next destination is Fezabel Marsh. We can go through it, through Thenmont, through the Arklan Quag, or Quag, or however you pronounce it. It's, I think, three pathways away from Thenmont. And of course, there's loot to pick up there.
Has our eminent tactician figured out how the enemy plans to cross Fezabel Marsh?
I'm afraid not. During the Renom season, the marsh flow weakens enough to make a crossing possible. But spirit climb changes have been thrown off kilter. The marsh flow should remain active.
What's this marsh flow?
The marsh's many bodies of water are linked together, with their water flowing through underground channels. If you were to fall into one, you'd get carried off to who knows where.
Oh, that wouldn't be a problem. I'm a great swimmer.
The maze of channels is quite complicated. It could be 10 years before you're finally pulled to the surface.
Yikes. Don't know if I can hold my breath for that.
And yet the enemy intends to cross it with a full army. That leads me to one conclusion.
That Arjul has a tactician even greater than the conductor himself?
Yes.
What I'm probably going to do right now is quickly get myself to Fezabel Marsh, because the Arklan Quag doesn't have too many new enemies. There is a lot of treasure chests and loot bags to pick up, but as usual, I'll probably do that off screen because there's nothing of great importance to pick up there.
It's been a while since you've been back to Thenmont. Don't you want to visit any of your friends?
Yeah, sure.
Wait, you didn't make any friends while you were here?
I made plenty of friends. It feels like it's been forever since I went to school here.
So I'm going to quickly get through these three pathways to get to the marsh. So I'm going to avoid as many battles as I can, but if I can't avoid them, I will fight, of course.
I understand that humans haven't engaged in large-scale warfare since the Battle of Fezabel 20 years ago.
For someone who doesn't meddle in human business, you sure seem to know a lot about our history.
I read a book about recent human history while I was convalescing in Lorand.
You read it in a book? Guess Jude's not the only honor student.
The book confirmed my theory. Humans haven't changed one bit since ancient times.
And I suppose your impression of ancient times also comes from a book.
Did you say something?
Oh, I just said that as long as humans never change, we mercenaries will never go hungry.
Oh, that's some fine staffmanship.
I'm still learning. I won't quit training till it's an extension of my body.
Your dedication to your art is admirable. It puts mine to shame.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Now don't get all psyched up just because she praised you.
Whatever, I'm psyched! Yeah! Ow! My head!
See? What did I just tell you?
No! Oh. it really hurts.
He'll be fine. Here, I'll take care of it for you.
Leia truly handles her staff well. But Jude handles Leia even better.
Clouds are gathering up.
And my old bones tell me it will be a heavy rain indeed. Practice a little.
A little?
Yes, only 20, 30 years or so.
All right, not bad.
I'm all puffy and wet.
I hate being puffy and wet. Tipo's swelling from all the moisture.
Many of the provisions we packed are nearing their expiration date.
You sure do sweat the little things. I'm surprised you could handle being a tactician.
It is a tactician's duty to consider and prepare for every possible complication. Momentary oversights bring enduring wounds.
But isn't it also true that a moment's hesitation can lead to a lifetime of regret?
It is. Which is why a leader must make snap decisions without hesitation.
Then I shall make the call. We will continue to eat the provisions until 2 months past the expiration date.
Yes, ma'am. You must love that about her. The fact that she can cut through all your worries in an instant.
Are we talking about the way I feel about her or the way you do?
Now, this area is a good place to train up because Fezzable Marsh is actually quite difficult. The enemies there are no pushovers, so if you are unlevel, this area is your last chance to gain some levels beforehand. I think this should be the last area before I get to the marsh. And as soon as I get to the marsh, you can guess that there's going to be a couple cutscenes. So I did tell you there's going to be more cutscenes than action this time.
Onward.
Identify yourselves. State your names, ranks, and divisions.
I am Rowan Ilbert, Chief of Staff, Rashagal Army.
The Ilbert? As in the conductor?
Correct. I wish to be briefed at once regarding our troop strength and deployment.
Yes, sir. Please proceed.
This table creates a tactical diagram of the battle by reading signals from the soldiers' Lilium orbs.
Hey, how come this one looks different?
That division is taking part in a special operation being led by the Deputy Chief of Staff himself. Agria of the Chimeriad attempted to block them, but it appears they broke through.
Gillen's operation?
Yes. He should arrive at the operation site a little after 1300 hours. We've been given no details, although we hear this operation will turn the tide of battle in one fell swoop. We've been ordered to concentrate as many troops as possible around that site when the operation commences.
With this route, his destination must be here, correct?
Yes, sir. Precisely. I should have expected nothing less from the conductor.
I do not like where this is heading.
Yes. No doubt he has plans to use the Lance of Kresnik. Yet why did he leave his own army in the dark?
Do you think we can catch up to them before they use the Lance?
I don't know. I hope so.
I stole the key required to activate the Lance. I entrusted it to Ivor.
We figured that would be enough to stop anyone from using it.
Nevertheless, it has been deployed, and they are likely readying it for use. That can only mean one thing.
They may have created a new key.
How is the Azul army marching across the marshes? I don't believe Renome ever arrived.
Are you familiar with the boosters that Azul has developed?
Hey! Quit staring at me like that! I hate being objectified!
The enemy is using them to amplify their mana output and alter the spirit climb in their immediate area.
In other words, they use mana to summon vast amounts of Earth spirits and force the spirit climb into Renome. They've actually changed the seasons. A brilliant strategy. One only Wingull could have conceived.
How has Rashagal responded?
We too have boosters.
So you issued one to every soldier, and assigned one man in every squad with the job of altering the spirit climb.
Yes, sir. Exactly as you said.
That sounds like a job for us, Elise!
No, this is Rowan's turf. He's an expert in the use of Earth arts.
We have no time. We must intercept Gillen's division. Might I borrow one of your spare boosters?
Chief Ilbert, there's one thing I should mention about the boosters. We keep hearing rumors that their use leads to a serious side effect.
Which is?
They say prolonged use saps your strength.
You mean it leeches away your very life?
The severity of this effect seems to vary wildly among those afflicted. Just to be safe, I suggest you avoid using the booster for long periods.
Sure you want to be standing out there in the rain?
Wait, what? But I swear I heard you from over here.
Say what? You hit your head or something?
Making up lies again?
Jeez, Elise, give me a break.
I'll give you a break, all right, you big fat liar!
You ready to string me up too?
Come now. Given the circumstances, it's only natural for us to become suspicious when you wander off on your own.
Just stick close to us from now on.
Seriously, promise us.
Fine, fine.
The key to Rashagal's strategy is the hill that overlooks the basin where the two armies are fighting.
You believe they will set the Lance of Kresnik there?
It seems likely. From there, they can snare the entire enemy army while they're all gathered together. If the Lance of Kresnik truly is a mana-powered weapon, it would be a very advantageous location. But to think Deputy Chief of Staff Gillen could pick out that spot so accurately is quite a surprise.
Such a man must not be taken lightly.
I had always thought him a talentless lickspittle, who won his position by flattering Noctegal. But it may be time to reassess that opinion.
Alright, so this video is pretty long already, so I'm going to end it here and cross the march next time. So thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you.